Welcome back to the Party 14 Counter-Strike Global Offensive competition here. We are here at the Grand Final and the third map at that between ECV GT, also known as Groetjes Thuis, and Mouse Control. Knife round has actually gone the way of MCON, so MCON will start CT side or T side. At least they get to pick. It's going to be CT side, I believe, because Kinzo opted to go for that CT side. So they will start on that side on this map, and of course this is MCON's pick. First map that was played before this went the way of GT.
Yeah, and they also had one map advantage because they came in through the winner's bracket, and MCON plowed their way through the lower bracket, taking down the likes of Asterion on their way, and of course Sequence that put them in the lower bracket to begin with. So a nice revenge there, and catch up. And Glitz going quite aggressively into tunnels, trying to get some information. And ECV knows they usually do this and hold up outside the tunnels. Silo gets down, Lil's Revo in the middle. And the guys are just waiting up and doing some mid to B smokes. Ooh, the flank. Glitz fails.
Is he going to realize in time that he's going to get pushed from the back? Though doesn't land the shot there. And wow, Kinzo just rattles off a shot towards Flash Short.
Still a very, very difficult thing to do. Doing a 2v4 retake on the B bomb side on Dust 2. It's nearly impossible, especially if you don't have flashes, and especially as Amos doesn't have armor and they don't have a kit. Kids are taken down. Amos takes down one and gets taken down by the second.
The pistol round actually going the way of ECV GT there, so that is a good start for them on this map, especially as it's MCON's pick, so to pick up a pistol then is always nice. So let's see if MCON are actually going to opt to force buy and force the issue here. Yes, they will. Three deagles in 2 5-7s there. Ketchup also has a defuse kit.
Team player again, and Impulse just going in, and Kinzo.
Oh, wow!
Clash taking his time on Kinzo. Sit back a little bit. A lot of damage dealt though by MCON Esports.
Oh, look at Klitz actually. He's pushed up through middle already to cut off the rotation back towards middle. Misses a shot there onto Flasher. If he had actually connected with a body shot there, Flasher would have been down as he is only on 22 HP right now. Klitz sadly could not connect with the shot. He's actually spots him going towards. Wow, what a shot there from
headshot as well. Jumping.
Flasher just gave him across the map UMP headshot. That is brilliant there. Looks like they will actually be making their way back towards that A-long area of the map. Ketchup is lying in wait on the A-site. He also has that kit. So if they opt to go to this side, yes, and they will. Looks
already
like
moving up, but Ketchup is holding a very passive angle. Lil's Revo taken down. And Ketchup takes on one in the second.
Ketchup
goes the 1-1. The force buy pays off, and now the money on ECV isn't too bad actually. They could force quite easily with at least one AK, but they go for the eco. And Klitz notices as well the jumping headshot with the UMP from T-spawn all the way to mid doors.
That is insane. That is an insane shot. I think Flasher didn't even realize he hit him because it was so far away.
Yeah, but you usually hear like
yeah.
That sound.
What?
Yeah, it's the best impression I can do, mate.
What sound?
So I'm not that kind of voice actor. So now they're going for a mid to B split, and Kinzo misses the first opportunity. Still, Clash is closing. Kinzo, very aggressive, flashes out, takes down Clash. Should fall back here. Definitely should fall back, and especially now, still going in. Pinky Squad Abdul Rappers just left the game. I don't know who it is. But
I don't know who that is as well. And Kinzo is going to get rushed down here from Xygo. Lands the shot on Xygo. Spinner will take him down though with the P250. Amos is sitting here in the pit. Not going to find any action as no one's over towards that A alongside. It is Flasher who is just around the mid doors with that Glock. Going to try to take down Lewis Raver. Lewis Raver is actually on 37. 73. No, 37. I was saying it right. But Amos will come in from the back and take down Flasher and spin him.
Bit of a waste from Kinzo there. Even though he had the UMP, he only had a USP when he pushed after. Should just fall back and have his mate coming from the B side helping out. Crossfire it. And right now they're opting to upgrade most of the weapons, except for Lil's Revo again with the UMP, whereas EZV has 4 AKs and a Deagle on Impress. Nades though. But quick move to the short, whereas Mental has 3 guys on long.
GT is actually going for a very fast short push there. Xayo will pick up that first frag onto Kinzo moving in towards that side. It is actually Ketchup and it is Amos who are retreating back towards that A-long and going to wait for the teammates to maybe go for this retake. There is a kit on Amos. There's a kit on Ketchup. So they have the 5-second defuse timer. And
doing a one-way smoke there by KLS, Clash. Confused by the name right here, but he has been spotted, slightly damaged, but still the retake isn't coming in right now. It's, time is ticking out.
Clash gets taken down. Surely the defuse is not going to come in anymore. Clitz will take down Clash, but spin him. It's over towards short. Lil's Revo still opts to push through that smoke, and if they stay here, actually two players from GT might die. No, actually none of them die.
Clitz only 1 HP though.
Clitz only on 1 HP and Xayo was on 10 HP, so they escape and they survive by the skin of their teeth.
No money on MCON Esports, they can drop one M4 but the other, and an AWP for Ketchup even. So, full buy, little nades, and full buy with quite some nades on the EZV side.
Right now, Amos. Just making sure he has gun control again, and he's just telling Ketchup, you can rotate off, I've got it.
Yeah, it's often
that's
very...
all good.
It's often very standard to just take down long control with two guys, because if there's a fast push, you really need to have two guys to trade efficiently there. And afterwards, one just falls back to hold mid, and another one goes for instance, short. But now they stop the push with a smoke, which leaves the gap. Which isn't too bad, they're scared to go through, waiting for the strength of Kinzo, playing in the CT, or maybe catch up with the AWP, playing at car.
Ketchup is actually playing at car, like you said, with that AWP, he's has his eyes trained towards that short. He's gonna get flashed up once, he's gonna call that out to his teammates, he's gonna land the first, yes he will. We'll have the first shot there onto Spinner, and Clash will go down to his AWP as well. Will he pick up his third? Yes, he will! Xayo down as well, Imprez. Now, the last man remaining on that push, and it's Flashor, who is now finding himself in a 1v5.
Yeah, just feeding them one by one into Ketchup's hungry AWP, and nothing he can do. It's such an easy hold. Just one spot he needs to hold, one line, actually, and just click away. Easy. And a save for Flasher, of course, 1v5, impossible. Time, 15 seconds. And MCON can't really hunt this either.
I was actually surprised by GT there, that they didn't go for a flash or try to flash Ketchup there.
Yeah, only one, I think they ran out after. And I think they were really scared by Kinzo and Flasher even taking down Amos now. Which is quite important because the money situation on MCON isn't too healthy. And Luos has to drop for his mate and lacks the nades right now.
Well, as of right now, it is going to be another buy round. It is a clash on a Tech 9. No nades to work with as well. And it is again Amos over towards Aeong, having seized control.
V going for the Xbox smoke right now, just to see if he can push up mid, block the AWP side, and it goes out, and in a few seconds it will pop and they will move up short, with one guy lurking from the lower B halls and one in the upper B halls moving towards as well. Ketchup changed up his position, now on the A ramp.
I think eventually GT are either going to opt for that short push or gonna go mid to B, but as of right now, it looks like they will actually go for the short push as Spinem is also making his way through A long. Smoke is gonna go down at short though. Imprez is gonna call that out to his teammates, maybe delay that push. Looks like the bomb is actually gonna go over towards B, so eventually the mid to B will maybe come in. Who's Revo? The force to be reckoned with though in this spot if they smoke CT. Kinzo is going to be blocked off with the angle, but Lil's Revo most certainly is not, and he's sat there with the M4, and the push is on. It's going to be a mid to B, and Luz Ravo will find Flashel. Lands only one shot there. Impress will instantly get that revenge frag. And right now, Kurt's hiding in the corner of the side here. Spinem is going to move in. Going to catch him off guard. Impress and Spinem. The last two remaining Ts against Amos, Kinzo, and Ketchup. Ketchup actually has that AWP. Amos and Kinzo both with a kit. And Amos also has a grenade to work with. Kinzo is peeking around that corner. Amos is going to meet up with Impress. He's going to rattle off some shots. Call that out to his team. And no, now they know that there's only one player in the side. Kinzo will take him down. Now it's Impress stuck between two players. Well, actually, pick up the headshot on Amos, but Kinzo will instantly get that revenge frag, and that is 4-2 right now.
They'll just take that trade any day. They just want the round, and their money is getting better whilst the easy fees isn't. And right now, it's looking good for Amcom. They have the AWP, double AWP even. The Ketchup and Luos combo is getting loose, and if they are on fire, what will stop them? I don't think the Tech-9s will.
Well, as of right now, Kinzo again holding that middle. Very passively. Actually going to peek out a little bit. Not doing anything too overly aggressive, though. And Luz Ravo is still playing with that AW. 27 HP, actually, for Luz Ravo. Looks like GT are making their way up middle. Bomb is going to stay there. Xygo, you should get the hell out of there because you have those explosives on your back. Kinzo is in CT. He's rotating towards the back of middle again. Gonna spot Xylo, rattles off some shots. Klitz tossing out a nade. Actually taken down, I believe. It was actually Impress was all the way over to the other side. Impress is down to 22 HP from some nades on short. Short is gonna be the name of the game. Short push is going to be the name of the game, I should say. And Ketchup is lying there, sitting there with his AWP, waiting.
Eagerly awaiting the push. A very good flash, stopping them slightly, but they're still going. One hit. Misses the second. The third.
Oh, he lands that one. And now it's all on Spinem. Can't land the shot. Amos is all the way over in pity. He's not going to win that battle with a Tech-9. So, 5-2.
Still very good positional play by the guys of MCON Esports every time, just waiting around and just covering each other, playing slow, methodically. Now the nade to cross because it's cheaper than the nade, and they will stop a possible rush with Molotov. Early flash in from the GT side, who have a reasonable buy again. Split out as a default, pushed up long a little bit. Amos playing a very passive angle now, as Ketchup has been boosted up to short together with Kinzo. And now they will move the other way around.
And actually, the rounds are going very slow in this first half here on Dust2. Neither of the teams is actually overpeaking. And I've seen MCON do this a lot, actually, where they do not go for the A-long control. Actually, they put up Ketchup there. He's just going to hold the A-long push. And it's Kinzo and Amos who are both holding short, making sure they have cat control, as that was the name of the game of GT for the two rounds they've won, I believe.
Yeah, so, and also the game versus Asterion for GT. They just kept on going. And Amos actually accidentally drops, I think. But Kinzo goes after him because he's scared as well. And it looks still like a short push. Nate's raining in. And some love barrel through the head of Amos from Kinzo.
Well, Ketchup is all the way up on that. Oh, Impress will actually come in from long. Ketchup didn't realize there was a player coming in from long as well. And Flashor is actually going to get some shots off. Impress,
Amos
4
for the
HP.
Ace. Amos for the ace.
Will Amos get the ace?
Both are one hittable. The flash gives it away. He wants to shoot, but he waits. He misses the shot, and he will be taken down now. Yes, 1v1, 5 seconds. He has enough time to get the bomb down. Luz Ravo, 1v1.
1v1 situation right now. Luz Ravo is not going to lose a battle like that.
And some screaming, just to see if the other guys had something, because that's what he asked them. And now they're going to win. this round, Amos always shines at the 1v1s.
And takes his head clean off with that AWP.
Yeah, why not? It's just like Scout, right? Has a scope, moves a bit slower, but still. Double up again, catch a bison, hits himself one. Money going down the drain for Emcom, but still a very good buy. Whereas Flesher opting for the Luos Revo UMP.
Let's actually see. Klitz is going to toss out that Molotov super early there. Xylo is going to be at the back of those halls. Kinzo will play close towards those mid doors. There's actually three players towards those tunnels. Kinzo plays it safe. Oh, he's going to get pop flash. Kinzo is actually going to do the same thing. Retreat back towards CT. Does not land the first frag. Impress will take him down. Luos Revo now forced to rotate out of there. Going to peek once again. Just peek once. Klitz is sure going to hold tunnels. Luos Revo. Oh, just turns around. Brilliant little shot there. Xayo, though, coming in with two of his own. Two into the situation right now. Amos and Ketchup, both with a kit. Ketchup with an AWP. And it is Flashdoor and Xayo, the old AT Gaming Black teammates, up against one of their former teammates. And Ketchup. And Ketchup will actually pick up the first. Almost picks up the second, but Amos will mop him up. Will mop him up. 7-2 right now, and this is going very strong for MCON, even on CT.
Yeah, it's a slightly T-side map. Of course, ESV is a very, very strong T-side team, so being crushed like this so far is quite important. And there is the tactical pass by ESV, I suppose. That's if it's a small technical difficulty, we'll take care of that. We have admins on the side, of course, and I think it's just a tactical pause because they're just sitting behind their computers.
Yep.
And they have the money to buy up, but not with full nades, that is.
No, they don't. And it is actually, like we mentioned before, a double op setup for MCON. Ketchup has been proven to be deadly with that AWP. And of course, we don't even need to mention the damage Luos Revo can do with that AWP. The big green gun.
Yeah, they're actually holding quite back this game. Luos Revo only on 5 frags, whereas Amos and Kinzo have 10 themselves, but they are very key, very pushing this game as well. And also being the backup when someone needs help, they're always there for them. Especially when Ketchup has to run, Amos will be holding his back, so no one can take him out. And Kinzo is doing pretty much the same. Bodyguards. That's what they are.
Bodyguards indeed, and GT are just going to try to work out a strategy, as they have lost so many rounds in succession. So, let's see what they're actually going to try. I mean, they tried cat control before, and it worked. At least they got on the site. They got the bomb down.
Yeah, one thing I'm really missing from the short executes from ESV is the very common CT drop. Usually throw a smoke so you can drop into CT safely. Maybe get down a pick right there because it's often one playing right there and the ready call comes out from Impress. And Flesher actually says no. And Kinzo says yes. And they're going to not impulse because Flesher now has a problem. So I think the communication might be also troublesome from the GT side.
And Let's just ask him if he wants a helicopter or a watermelon.
Before every match, they just put on SVGs and spawn some helicopters and fruit in the map to run around with. It's their way of relaxing, going tropical, they say.
Tropical indeed, and Flesher is asking for the go. So that means they will be ready. Match is going to be unpaused any time now.
MCON gives the ready as well, and the match is unpaused. Time is ticking down before the round will start. And
of course, GT buying up, buying AKs, a lot of smokes, a lot of flashes, so a good utility there. And, looks like it will actually be an aggressive push onto short. Kinzo said that after the game that he would do that more often. And it's actually Ketchup who's on top of his head holding the lower area. Kinzo is holding the middle. Ketchup is holding the lower area, but it's getting smoked off. Good Xbox smoke.
Otherwise, he would have easily had a guy in lower tunnel because Ketchup knows how to flick. And Kinzo's being boosted up with Amos again.
Yep.
Two-man short hold where Kinzo just holds long. Very interesting. But I'm slightly wondering if Clash might want to have like Glass Cannon Arms, because he has been so impactful, especially on Dust 2 with that gun. I think today is just not his day. I think he's buying it. But Kinso taken out by Impress. Again, the headshot machine taken down by Amos now. And Xylo, bad communication. Not sure what happened. He's dead.
Amos picks up a crucial double there. Klitz is actually... he's given away this B-bomb site. Bomb is going down. 3-on-4 retake right now. But then again, they have 3 flashbangs, a smoke and a grenade there on over at the MCON side. They have 4 kits, so they have all the time in the world and the utility to take back this bomb site. And Flash Short is in a good spot to hold off the B-tunnels push. In the meantime, Lewis Ravo trying to rattle off a shot. Clash behind Big Box. Clash Short actually picks up the first. They're onto Amos. That is a important frag. Clash will pick up one as well. Klitz will reply onto Clash. Klitz will get taken down from Flash Short. And right now, Lewis Rafe is just going to save his AWP. No, he can't. Spin him comes around. Takes him down. And that is the AWP down.
Almost dying there from the blast, this Flasher. But he survives. And I think it was a classic over-rotate. A bit too greedy. As they thought they read them, but they read them completely wrong. And now MCON has very low money. So the pause may have worked out, but it was also, I think, a bit of luck. And Spinem going for the Xbox smoke, I suppose, but it's on the second shadow from the lights. I'm not sure what he was getting at. It was Ravo holding the lower tunnel angle after having a nice smoke blocking his vision to top mid.
We got Spidem though, he's in a perfect position there to hold off this A long push. Amos and I think he saw Ketchup jumping away there. They're not going to expect Amos to be in that corner as well. Luis Ravo with that Deagle is going to meet up Flash or. Oh, gets off 2 shots. Does not land the headshot, does land the headshot eventually. Amos opts to push out of A long there. Spidem is going to take him down. Can Spidem pick up another? No, he can't. Right now it is Ketchup who's actually pushing them in the back, and he knows that it is going to be a short push, and Klitz can't do anything about this.
Barbara Klitz, I would just save the armor right now. It's an almost impossible retake with the only P2000 on Ketchup. He's already preparing for exit frags, and Klitz is in a
so is Klitz.
Position.
But he's actually in a very unorthodox position.
Scary spot though, very easy to collapse on. Ketchup is just hiding. Oh, Kukri! Kukri!
Will he go for the Kukri? Well, he goes for the Kukri, but it doesn't land the Kukri.
Yeah, way too risky. I would just walk up ramp then, or just at least keep our eyes on short instead of like throwing away the armor there. Because the money situation isn't too great, and they can use it.
Sadly, Ketchup can't get any exit frags as they do not opt to make their way out of that bombsite through short, so Ketchup is just sitting there. Actually, guns are flying around. Maybe if he's lucky, the Deagle even flew from CT spawn there, but doesn't find it on the ground. And right now, GT picking up their first round in a long time.
Yeah, Pislam is coming out from MCON Esports, because I think they want to opt for the double AWP setup again. Ketchup boosting Kinso once again. Amos going to be slightly later on the short. Flash maybe walking into the crosshair, looking away, and now he's looking there again.
Oh, but is Kinso gonna be? Oh, this is brilliant. Kinso just made his way through middle. Spinem could actually be caught off guard, but no, he actually expects it. He's gonna miss the shot. Oh. Kinso and Amos combine. The Eagle frags. Kinso with another. Kinso just applying the heat there with that Deagle, and as
tag
of right
team.
Now
when they were confused by Kinso's pushing up, they were looking on top mid, then Amos came around, takes one down, and then eventually they just trade around, trade the aggro and confuse the enemies. But now ECV, after getting one kill, they're moving up long, spotted both by Ketchup, will smoke it off, and a full nade set of ECV might make it easier for them.
Because Ravo needs to come in and maybe throw a flashbang for Ketchup here. Ketchup is just going to stand in this smoke. He's going to utilize that smoke that he just threw. Xayo expecting it though. Kinso is on that side. Ketchup.
He's now expecting it. He's looking. Takes down Ketchup.
Oh, Kinso Almost lands the third there, but right now it should be easy pickings for the Deagles of Lewis, Ravo, and Kurtz. Kurtz actually has an AK as well. He's going to come in from long, and this could be big. If Kurtz plays this well, this could be huge. Rattles off some shots, does not connect. Lewis Ravo now knows that. Oh, wow! Lewis Ravo comes in. Takes down Imprison. Nice shot there. Oh. Kurtz will mop up the last frag. Easy defuse going to come in, and MCON winning a round they should have never won.
Beautiful eco just by Kinso's ID. Let's just go. Why not? Gonna risk it. Why not? I have some other things to do today. I want to finish this faster. And the perfect backup with Amos just staying there to switch the aggro again so Kinso can come back for another one. And there we have it. The AWP for catch-up. And Lewis Ravo will go for the AK this time. And an AWP on Clash, finally.
They unleash the beast indeed, and it looks like it will be Bombus towards B. No fast push coming in as of yet though, but they're waiting for the Molly to be extinguished, and Klitz is over towards that back box. He's playing alongside Lewis Ravo, and is he gonna... Oh, he actually spots Clash there, and now he knows that this is gonna be a B push. Lewis Ravo will pick up one, and Klitz spots one jumping on top of the box. Gets flashed himself right now. Impress is still over towards big box. Cannot land a shot. Impress will take him down. Headshot. Impress with another headshot there onto Kinso. Now 1v4 ammos. All the way over at A side. Sure, you're going to opt to save his AK here. Instead of trying to go for a 1v4 clutch, which is most probably never going to happen.
Oh, ammos got with flash out and... Spinem takes his down. But, Impress really, really on fire with those headshots. Every time, he doesn't make the most kills, but he's quite impactful. Well, this match he does, but the last map he was more on the background, but still has a very, very big impact frags, getting those entries, those headshots, taking down people like Lewis Ravo. Just with one click. Whoa, almost being very lucky there. Clash messing a very easy shot, and he's standing around right there. Unfortunate and not smart, really. Catch up with only a P2000 saving because he has only a $1,400 taken down with ease by Xylo.
Right now, CT's Kinso has actually has body armor, so he might opt to save it. Well, he won't. Impress with another headshot there. Xylo is a super low. Is he going to get killed by the nade? Impress is going to get killed by the Deagle from Klitz there.
But the flank is also coming in from number 9, number Spin. He takes them both down. We're just delayed on the camera.
Well, happens.
Last round of first half. A very good comeback of BCV. And if MCON takes this round, I think they're doing quite well. And they need to shine on the T side. But a double AWP from ECV. Impress and Clash taking one home. And Lewis Ravo, the glass cannon AWP right now.
Ravo with the glass cannon AWP then in. If you ever want a glass cannon on anyone, you want it on Lewis Ravo.
Yeah, the man is just faster than lightning. And there will be a peek on mid or not. Will they do it? Number 7, Impress will try. Oh. Lewis Ravo misses a shot because he just flies by. Now helping Klitz to hold B. Falling it down. And Clash will probably take down someone from the A side if they are open for a shot. It plays passively, goes into pit.
I actually think MCON are not going to peek this A-long because they know Clash might have an AWP. They know they left A-long open, so it's basically a death trap to peek something like that. Kinso is actually boosted up on short. That is even more important. Amos holding mid, but Kinso is in a very good position here to pick up at least one kill. Won't, though. Impress will come around the corner, take him down. And right now, it is Ketchup in a very rough situation. Nate. He's gonna throw a nade. No,
one HP?
Oh, wow. That is so unlucky. That could have been a kill.
Yeah. Kinso peeked a bit too wide there on this peak on the short. Clash takes down Ketchup when he walks back, scared of long. I think Kinso should have peeked a little bit closer to the wall.
Yes, he should. And as of right now, Lewis Ravo is gonna peek towards middle. Make sure no one is flanking them. Amos sitting in that CT spawn. Sure, they're going to opt to save these guns as there is no point in walking into save these guns. Come on, we're on the last round.
Yeah.
Well.
They've just figured that out as well, and one down, but it's the one with one HP. Ooh. Sorry, that was
my bad. That was my 1 hour sleep talking.
It's nature.
It's the call of nature. Oh, anyway, nature. 8-7, that is a very balanced scoreline. And it's, like, I have to say, like, on Amcon's map, a map they are expected to take comfortably even, I don't know if this is, well, this is bad news.
Yeah, they're requesting a pass, and Ginzo, no, Ketchup is actually disconnecting. Probably some minor difficulties, and it will come soon. And Amcon didn't have the Archon typed in, so thank God he helped them out with a pass. Of course, very sportsmanlike behavior from both teams. Well, we have a mosquito joining us.
Yes, we have a mosquito joining us indeed. Anyway, 8-7 right now. It is just waiting for, I believe, that is Ketchup to join us again.
Yeah. Now, we can just look at the scoreboard right now. Looks like a very easy armor buy for both Spin and Flesher. Clash going for the kit. Actually, I'm quite surprised that the ARPers are... The game cache fix is coming in from Ketchup because he has some longer difficulties. Apparently something might have been corrupted, so I actually see them chilling around, just talking about some strats, talking about what went wrong, because Leos Draver was actually a man with always having some paper next to his computer, so when something goes wrong, he doesn't say it in the round straight away, he just keeps it for after the round, or at least some pause like this. And as I said, Clash, just as Dulce Revo in his CT side, going for the kit. Apparently they are very confident on that one. Meanwhile, I hear some bats being deflated as some people are already packing. We have some crowd sitting in front of the screen, in front of the guys, whilst we're still waiting for Ketchup. And he is incoming, Clit says. And Kinso is saying that Ketchup is warping a bit, and that's why he only got one round of 4K, otherwise he would have definitely had more. And that's just some banter again. Talking around, and flashes are apparently very expensive. Still waiting for our friend Ketchup. Now they're just discussing the game, and the bybinds come in. Who put this game on easy mode? You really gotta Windows. For those wondering what the next LAN will be, Sugarlan in 2 weeks will be in Belgium. Don't know if Gamers Up does the coverage for that, but of course most of these teams will also attend there. Ketchup is actually rejoining, so we will probably see a unpause coming in soon. They're now just bragging a bit, talking about how they got headshots on each other in the lower their tunnels. Still waiting for the impulse. They're just discussing the game right now. I don't think they want to play anymore. They're just talking about the round where Kinzo pushed up the top mid, got one kill, and then got one other in the tunnel. My co-caster is rejoining me. I was having a small toilet break, which is just nature. Ketchup disconnected again because he is now rebooting his PC. That happens. Happens to the best of us.
It happens to the best of us indeed, as is my co-caster is being said goodbye to by his beloved players.
It's always such an emotional goodbye, but they have to work as well, so they have to get back.
So Xylo just put his hard drive in the blender. It's fine now.
Yeah, it's also every problem you always have. Leave it. Ketchup Jeff hasn't done that before, but most people don't really take blenders to LAN parties nowadays. So it's apparently.
I do. I always take my blender with me, man.
Yeah. Yeah. Smoothies or just to make videos. Will it blend?
I always just blend my my hard drive as well. I do it with my RAM sometimes as well, man. It works out.
Just to flush it out, make sure no suspicious material that people can find on your disk or at least PC when they find you at events.
Exactly. So we're just waiting for Ketchup to reboot his PC so we can get back on our way. But anyway, our thoughts on this game so far. MCON not showing up as strong yet as they could. On the other hand, they've shown to have good T sides here on Dust 2, so they should be able to run away with this map. But
yeah, it really depends. If Kinzo and Amos keep doing what they're doing, they've been really, really strong so far. Really good teamwork on those guys, just backing up the Harpers, whereas usually Duos and Amos are a duo, and they take around Kinzo and Amos on Dust 2.
Yep.
If they keep doing what they're doing, it's going to be possible to win. ECV is very strong, Clash and Impress with the ARP, probably dual ARP setups coming in. Ketchup has returned. Flasher is waving
is.
To Jamie. He wants some attention.
He wants some attention, man.
Notice me, Senpai, notice
no.
me.
Wow. Anyway. The match should be unpaused anytime soon. I think all the players are. Flasher is just asking if he didn't just drop a Tech 9 before he reconnected. he's actually coming to inspect the floor.
You never know until you see it, you know. Ketchup seems to be doing stuff. So I think he might be alive.
What a time to be alive.
Possibly still having problems as there is no unpause yet. So we are curious if the problem is resolved, and if not, when it will be.
Well, actually hop on board with Ketchup. Let's see if he's actually moving around. He's swapping guns.
Oh, he's even typing.
Yeah.
Now they're talking about how beautiful the teammates are. Just bragging about that now. First we're bringing out kills now, the Byvines come in.
And Amos is asking, who put this game on easy mode?
Really got a Windows, Flasher says. Talking about some of those rounds that were really close.
Like I said before, these teams are good friends.
Pretty much every team is nowadays, at least in the Benelux scene. It's all fun and games.
It's all fun and games. That reminds me of that, I believe it's a Survivor song. Anyway, welcome to the jungle.
Yeah.
Anyway, should be good now. I mean, Ketchup seems to be alright. On behalf of PC issues, so we should be going underway in this game.
I don't see that in behind him, or at least maybe he's crouched next to them, but I don't see anything.
Actually, Clash is going for that flashbang. That was flashbang. Sorry, the fuse kit.
Oh, they're ready.
They're ready. They're actually gonna get. They're gonna say mouse control is ready. Kinzo is gonna say he's born ready. Impress. Gonna tell them his team is ready as well. So that means the long-awaited pistol round is now going live.
5 seconds. And that is.
in five seconds. That is. That was a bit of an anticlimax there. Anyway.
Cliffhanger though. Cliffhanger.
Anyway, looks like the pistol round bomb is going to go towards the long of A, or at least towards A slash middle. Going to play very, very passive.
Ketchup didn't buy anything this round. Does he still have $800?
Look at this aggressive. Well, indeed. Ketchup. I think Ketchup even forgot to buy.
Yeah, I think due to the problems he forgot to buy.
Spinem was posted up aggressively there. He spots Kinzo. Kinzo safely retreats, though. right now. Xylo over towards that long A. He's holding passively. Two of his teammates are over towards mid, so they can instantly rotate through that short. Impress spots a player towards T-spawn. Sees him drop into suicide. He's going to try to land the shot. It's Ravo. He'll deal 9 damage to him.
The Glock is amazing against the armor, isn't it?
Absolutely amazing. And as of right now, they're going to actually make their way back to B tunnels. But look at that. It's Spinem who's pushing towards T-spawn. Right now, Amos. Oh, no. Wrong guy. Kinzo.
So and who's Ravo? Fake, actually.
Bit to be fake. This is absolute complete chaos here. Actually, eventually the bomb is going to go towards A-Long. Xylo gets taken down with a headshot. Their Clash is going to meet up with a lot of players here. Rattles off some shots. Does not connect with any of them.
Oh.
And then he connects with that one. Clash just drops almost him. Takes down Luz Ravo.
Flesher gets the return frag and almost takes down Spin. And the last man is Flesher in the CT spawn. Blitz is manning up, doing some shoulder peaks. See if he's still there. Yeah. He's there. I'm not going to challenge him. Just going to booty him a little bit. Peeking out on the shoulder. Flesher moving up to the short with the pixel jump, which often people miss, and I always laugh at them. There he goes. Misses a few shots. Hits one on the A side guy. And decides to back off and save the smoke, the kit, and the armor that he picked up this round.
Yeah, I think that's actually the wise thing to do. He only needs to buy, for example, a 5.7, or you can even buy an SMG maybe now.
One guy of MCON actually died in the blast of the bomb, so only two guys saved their armor. And Ketchup, another Glitz, was actually injured, so I have to rebuy completely. Almost, seems he did as well.
Flasher is actually going to do exactly that. He's going to buy up that SMG because he saved that armor, he saved that kit. He's going to buy up that UMP. Flashers are coming out of beatdowns. It's going to be a fake, though.
Ravo, very important start of the round, where he only went glass cannon scout until he noticed he was not scouted back. He just bought armor, just to make sure he doesn't throw away any money by getting picked off early. And meanwhile, Kinzo and Ketchup, two frags in total, and they have mid and short control.
Look at Clash though, he's gonna push through an A-Long. Gonna meet up with Ketchup there. Ketchup is lying in. Wait, Ketchup will take him down, of course. Easy headshot angle there for him. Spin him. Moving towards T-spawn. Flasher doing the same. Flasher sure gonna save this SMG as he then has the element of surprise in the next round.
Yeah, and he still has the armor and the kit, and I think Spin will also save as he has a pistol and a kit. Glitz on the hunt again. For more money, because he doesn't have a lot, so it's risky.
Flesher.
Just by Flesher. Not spotted any.
Flesher just holding his angle on Klitz is surely going to realize something is up, and he might even meet up with Flesher here. Yes, he does. Oh, Flesher goes down. That is actually unlucky there for our man Flesher. Spin him with that CZ, and the head armor is in this corner.
Spot him. Ooh. Well,
that was just a second too late there, but still.
This was actually checking whether he was so close to the corner and didn't have a barrel peeking out, so by doing that, he managed to save it.
And Clash is actually saving up for an AWP. We can see him on 3.5k.
Reman boost on short, quite interesting. Very aggressive style. But MCON is actually pushing along. Flesher takes down Ketchup, and Luos takes down Clash. Will meet Spin. Spin dodges. CZ and armor doesn't save you, my friend, as he dies to Luos Ravo. Klitz gets some money for a UMP, and they will.
Oh! Luos Ravo fills his smoke as he gets blocked by Amos there. Just a tiny bit. It's enough to basically let that smoke go on a path it is not supposed to.
It's a fancy 360 just to check, am I alright? Am I seeing things straight? Is it alright? And then Xylo is with the AK, of course, in short. I will personally save this. It's really important and expensive asset. I don't really see such an afterplant being taken down by the guys of ECV.
Especially as the guys of ECV do not have a kit. They don't have armor. Their chances in this round are very slim. Flash Sword in CT. Will actually pick up the kill there.
Second with his USP.
Flash Sword is going ham with that USP. Amos will take down Flash Sword. He tries to push through CT. Clits and Amos are both going to save their guns in the depths of the pit of A-Long.
And the bucket comes flying to Clits. He throws away his Galil. Doesn't want it. Wants an AK. I think Lurzevo will opt for the AWP as he's more an aggressive AWP where Ketchup is more the defensive man. But sometimes they switch it up and Sam Ketchup takes it out.
Oh,
she peeking mid, not hitting anyone. Clash also having an AWP. Ketchup taking down Impress, who had an M4 this round, not an AWP. And Spin being blitzed down, walking through, taken down by Clash. Pressure every time. With Clash on his side, taking down two guys at the B. The door is smoked, and now they're boosting over the smoke.
Oh,
see,
this is
big
brilliant.
Box.
This is brilliant. Clash will pick up Clits if he opts to
oh,
move
the flash.
Oh, the flashes are so good there. That actually saves Clits' life.
I was almost scared he would just walk through, and the re-smoke as well. The bomb is quite late, so the smokes will dissipate before the time runs out for the CTs to do anything. Luos has a very awkward position. Going back to car, the molly is too deep from Lurzevo. Man goes in, Clits takes him down eventually, fully flashed, very happy, and Clash and Flesher, who has only has 1 HP, will fall back and save their rifles.
Yes, they will, and it is actually the wise thing to do. I mean, if Clash can hold on to that AWP, they still have a fighting chance in the next round. See if they are they're actually gonna buy next round, but as Clash has that AWP and Flesher has that M4, they might opt for it to go for a force buy.
Yeah.
Let's see if that is gonna happen. Flesher could potentially drop an M4 or FAMAS.
Yeah, a lot of people actually go for an eco even if they have an AWP, and I'm just always saying matchmaking, perks, just get that force out. You have the AWP, it's very important as it will change the round. Just get one kill on every person and you win the round usually.
Look at the M4 is actually at the GT side. They managed to drop enough guns to fully equip them. Spinem will take down Kinzo. As I think Kinzo expected a... I'm not sure why Kinzo is pushing by his
He expected an eco, and I think he had a Mac-10 if I recall correctly. I thought I saw it.
But even then, pushing through a thick smoke at B and the biggest choke point of all.
YOLO.
Not sure if... Yeah, YOLO indeed, but...
He is the youngest player, so slightly... well, unstable maybe, in that sense, not as relaxed and calm as the older guys, such as Lurzevo and Ketchup. It's also very important to have those players to mix up your playstyle. Lurz will go for the CT smoke.
They're actually gonna, I think they're gonna fake this mid to B, and then Amos is trying to make his way out of A-Long.
He's also checking the flash of his teammate, saying, mate, that one's too short, I can't do anything with that.
It's actually working as Clash rotated off just now. It is Lurzevo who has made his way up through middle. Spin him. Moving that mid to B. Lurzevo is going to come around the corner. Takes down Spin him.
Will get flanked though in a 3-2. Oh, wait. Yes.
Yes, he
has
will.
Has 3 bullets.
Oh, oh! Takes down Impress. Brilliant little 1 bullet to the face.
And a 3-B. For Empoli Esports. Glitz sees one on mid, can't take him down, does tag him up, and a nade will do no damage whatsoever.
Well, surely ECV, GT are going to save these guns once again. Clash and Xargo opting to play safe, saving those valuable guns, AWP and M4. Right now, MCON is running away with it. They have proved that their T-side is indeed extremely good. They have gotten 4 rounds, make this the 5th, 5 rounds in a row.
Yeah, on average, the ECV side will have roughly $3,000 each. And, so they can buy a FAMAS if they want with only Kevlar. Wouldn't know if they would want to do that. Would you wait for the 14th round or actually buy it right now? See if we can force it up.
Not when the deficit is this big. I think you want a surprise buy as well, especially if you can drop 2 guns. I think they're gonna, and they're gonna do exactly that. They're gonna drop 2 guns and they're gonna go for the full buy once again. They don't have a lot of equipment though. Well, Flasher and Impress do, but Spinem and Clash don't have much to work with. Looks like it will actually be a B, and I think MCON is expecting this to be an eco.
Yeah, they are, and he's just
Kinzo,
going.
Again, just gets taken down instantly. Amos will reply, though, but Spinem will pick up three! The last frag there was through thick smoke, and now it's all on Amos. Amos will pick up the first, and he picked up the second. No, he does. Yeah, he actually picks up the second, but Xylo already chimes in with a revenge frag of his own. 13-8 here.
The money on MCON is really good, but this is just what ECV needed to get back into the game. Build some back, and don't lose too many members. Only two went down, so they are making bank. Slightly.
Anyway. It looks like MCON was caught off guard there by... wow, look at this boost. Look at this boost. This is actually... I've not seen this too often. The close mid-smoke and then boosting over the smoke. That's actually really, very cool.
It's really risky, especially if Klitz would push on, but they can just peek low.
Oh, Klitz.
They're pushing everywhere. There is the aggressive ECV that we are used to. Klitz will just fall back. Just wait. And Clash, the familiar spot that we've seen against Asterion many of times, which they weren't able to cope with, only with flashes and hoping he would not shoot them while blind. Actually a boost onto the A side, where there might be a battle between Yarps if Lewis Revo is able to take down Clash. But he goes onto the short with Impress, and Lewis Revo takes out Clash regardless in front of the side. It's down, Kinsa takes one. Klitz taken down by Impress.
Oh, Impress. Impressive play there as he picks up two headshot catchable. Actually, just peek around there. Spinem tries to take him down. Doesn't land the headshot, and Ketchup punishes him for him there.
Last man, Flesher, in the short, in the lower tunnels right now. And will to go for long. See if he can tap away and get Ketchup with a one tap and Lewis with a two tap, maybe. But Lewis Revo has the ARP, has the range advantage. Is spotting. Oh, a dink, 3 HP and a Molotov. Is not fatal as it will land for the long plant. Ketchup just hiding, Lewis just hiding, waiting for Flesher to make the mistake. Lewis missing. Ketchup with him. Lewis dropping, being chased. He loads, he plays the time. There's Ketchup. Oh, dearie
Ketchup
me.
Ketchup actually goes down. Will he spot Lewis over? Yes, he will.
Does
he will
time?
Actually clutch. He will actually clutch this round.
Wow.
Wow, what just a play there from Flasher. Sure, he's going to pick up the AWP as well for his teammate Clash, and that was brilliant. The long range dink there instantly onto Lewis Revo. And Ketchup, actually...
Choking
a little bit, yeah.
If he would have hidden, which is illogical, but still would have been better, he would have survived and Flasher would have died after, because he would have to force the issue and he might have thought that Ketchup would be on the A shore.
Klitz is going to be the only one towards those halls. Again, we've seen them play the setup the previous round as well, as the rest of MCON are preparing for a push at the top of middle. Kinzo is going to hold off a long, make sure no one pushes there unscathed. Spinem is going to boost his teammate Impress up if there is ever going to be a mid to B execute. Amos making his way through middle, there's Revo as well. Actually looking to be, this could very well be a mid to be, at least the Goose. Revo is going to toss out that smoke to fake the mid to be. Amos is going to actually make his way through. Amos of course does not know Impress is boosted up in here. Amos is actually going to make his way through. This could actually make the boost here for Impress pay off, and he rattles off the shots, will pick up the headshot eventually onto Amos there. In the meantime, Flashor not gonna get pushed from that B tunnels area. Impress is at the back of middle. He's gonna see Kinzo, he's gonna actually dink him. That is Kinzo down to 14 HP. Flash goes out, doesn't land a second.
Wow.
Very ballsy peek there, not paying off there for Impress. Lewis Revo will take his head clean off, and now it's Clash. He needs to hold off this short push, will land the first. He'll land the second or even a third. Rattles off a shot. Not connecting though, and this is actually the way you should push short. There is even or not. Oh, Molotov actually cooking Kinzo alive there. He only has 14 HP. Gonna cook Klitz as well. doesn't realize the Molotov is going to bleed.
Yep. Panicking because of the time, but if he just waited a little bit longer, he would have just stayed alive and planted for short safely. It's a bit of a throw in now. They are very low on cash, and ECV is getting very, very close right now. And MCON is opting to go for the force buy, it seems. They're just chilling around the spawn for a little bit longer.
Just going to talk things through, and what I actually like is that ECV, even though the timeout they called wasn't a tactical one. No, they didn't even call a timeout, I believe.
No, it was MCON with ketchup with the technical difficulties.
Of course, yeah. But they got three rounds in a row now as CTs, and this is they're looking stronger than ever right now on this CT half. Looks like it will be a full-on B push here from the MCON side. Fleshor is going to toss a flash out towards that tunnel. Fleshor is going to toss another flash and take down ketchup. He's going to shoot Kinzo down to 10 HP. Doesn't land the USP shot, though. Still, 4-3 situation. Kinzo and Amos are both low. Molotov is going to come out from Imperz. Just a little bit too short. Kinzo and Amos just outside those doors. There is one problem with this, though. If a Klitz cannot land a shot onto the player in tunnel there, Xayo needs to take the battle versus Klitz. Going to peek around. Does he spot Klitz? Yes, he spots Klitz. Will take his head clean off there. And eventually Clash will have two kills of himself. So that is another round there for GT. 13-11. And MCON really need to change something up right now, because whatever they're doing, it's not working.
No, they really need to eco now. Oh no, they actually can buy because of the loss bonus plus the bomb bonus. So there will probably be an AWP. No AWPs
there won't
this
be an
round.
AWP. There won't be an AWP. And maybe they will go for a slight faster push here, as I believe.
A long, it seems,
work.
A rampage with Glitz again lurking through the B tunnels.
Glitz lurking through the B tunnels. A long is fully controlled here by mouse control. Clash is gonna fire off a shot. Lewis Ravo baits that out.
And again.
And again, and again. Oh, he actually doesn't spot him, but Clash gets the flick. Nice little shot there from the younger player, Clash. I do not mean that by age, but I mean that by experience. But Klitz still over at those B halls, bending off the push, making sure no one is gonna do something that might catch them off guard. Imprez again boosted up on those boxes in the CT spawn. If there is going to be a mid to B, which it is shaping up to be, Imprez is gonna pick up a lot of kills here. The Klitz is making himself ready for that mid to B. Imprez is just waiting for them to run up the ramp. He spots Ketchup, but Amos, wow, what a shot there. Klitz as well. Now it's all on Spinem, who gets taken down from Kinzo, and right now it's a 2-on-2 situation. And Amos picking up a very important frag there onto Imprez, who was boosted up on the box. It's a very, very important
shame
kill.
Shame he wants full on. That's Jamie twice, full on me, or I don't know the thing, but it's something like that.
I think it's fool me once.
Oh yeah.
Anyway. Oh, Amos with his, I think it's his second of the round or his third of the round. Anyway, Amos is picking up amazing kills here for MCON, and that is the 14th round, and that is the round they so desperately needed. And I have to say, Amos on Dust 2 again, 23-16. This man is a monster on this map. And
yeah, this series as well, just stepping up, bodyguarding everything, and not really clutches, but very stable, knows what angle to hold and tells his teammates what to do, what to hold. And with Kinzo as well, every time, the team. Ooh, Ketchup and Duels Ravo. Long. Ooh, now losing track. Kinzo taking down Impress, the headshot machine. Blitz will take down Spin Fleshor. Only one left spotted at mid doors. Blitz will hold the angle, will go into tunnels, throw a nade, smoke even. Fleshor's like, I'll go CT. There's no time for him to catch the ones who've already gone through, and he's walking through the Molotov to take him down.
Lazareva will take him down. Of course, he heard him running through that Molotov. He heard the damage being dealt, so he's just going to check that smoke gap, make sure no one runs in and kills his teammate on the side there. Now it's 15-11. It is map point for MCON, and it is it is their chance to make this best of five series into 2-1.
Yeah.
Still in favor of GT though, but of course, if they lose this map, they're out.
Yeah, again, it's a very, very exciting match. Just like the last one, very close rounds, very. Attack for the smoke, and Kinzo on the other side of the map, taking down the mid push, reloading casually while Xylo is close. Ooh, ducking underneath one, but not ducking underneath the second kill.
Amos. Oh, Amos, nice shot there.
Dying to spin though, who will now pick up the AK, go to Klitz, and Klitz take down spin, punish him for killing his teammate.
Whereas, with the only a deagle to work with, Flash Short has the same gun in his inventory. Impress has two flashes though. It's like eventually it's shaping up to be a catwalk push. Klit spots a player pushing outside of B. That is Flash Short. 41 HP left on him. Impress is gonna peek out in the middle. 41 HP left for him as well. Ketchup is gonna take down Impress as he tried to push out the middle doors, and now it's all in the hands of Flash Short. Has an AK to work with now. Luz Ravo's keeping his eyes trained there. Will pick up the headshot, and that is map for Mouse Control.
The third map going in favor of Emcon. 2-1 for ECV right now. And the next map will be Cheat Train.
It will be Train, actually. And you guys might be wondering, we have only seen two maps. Why is he referring to this as the third map? That is because ECV GT are 1-0 up as they came from the upper bracket. That being said, we're going to go on a small break as the players are going to go take a small break as well. We will be right back with you guys with some more Counter-Strike action. Stay tuned.